there. Let's take a walk.
Welcome to Sugarloaf Mountain. This is a popular hiking spot about 10 minutes from downtown Marquette, Michigan. It's a rocky, route-heavy path with more than enough stairs and is about 20 minutes to the top if you take the easy route. I came here because I had time to spare before lunch, but also because I've been thinking about time recently, and there are few better opportunities to think about time than while climbing a mountain. One thing I love about Sugarloaf is that it's way more important than you might give it credit for at first glance. At barely 1,000 feet above sea level, it's not particularly tall compared to other places. It's also not particularly pointy or jagged, and from the road, it just looks like a collection of trees sloping upward. But in reality, Sugarloaf is right at the heart of North America. So in geology, there are these ancient masses of rock called cratons that make up the nucleus of every continent. They haven't changed significantly in a billion years or more, and they've stuck around even as other land masses have collided and been recycled. In North America, there's a section of our craton called the Canadian Shield, and Sugarloaf Mountain is part of it. It's made of granite about 2.7 billion years old, making it some of the oldest rock in the world and about 60% the age of the Earth itself. But at first, it wasn't a mountain. At first, this place was just a bit of granite sandwiched between other layers of rock. And if the world hadn't changed, it might have never made our maps. But the Earth has changed, a lot, and the years came for this place too. First 1,000, then 1,000,000, then 1,000,000,000 and more. And those other layers of rock, they wore away and were scattered. But this granite was harder, so it didn't erode. The granite stayed. The earth grew low around it, and so the mountain grew tall. And today, it's a place of beauty that sticks with you for years, that draws you back even when you're already exhausted and your legs hurt. And why is it this hot in mid-October? Over the long, unbroken stretch of years, this granite became a mountain, simply by being itself. Now, I know I'm kind of personifying there. Some rocks are just harder than others. There's not anything particularly special about that. But I did say I've been thinking about time recently. Specifically, this April, I officially entered my late 20s, and lately, I've been thinking about this idea of the long, unbroken stretch. How, for the first time in 15 years, if not more, there are no predictable, big changes ahead in my life. We aren't looking to move, I'm not expecting a huge career shift, I'm not waiting for anything big to happen, and there's no feeling of, well, you only have 4 years of college, so enjoy them, or you're only in this town for a little while longer, so soak it up. It's just the start of a long, unbroken stretch, a time where I can learn to experience a place slowly, as opposed to packing everything in all at once. And for as freeing as that sounds, it's harder than you might think, for me, at least, mostly because it's new. Still, something about climbing Sugarloaf was reassuring in the midst of all of that. Over time, and ignoring continental drift, this mountain has stayed in one place and been 1,000 things at 1,000 times. It's served as the heart of North America, as North America formed and took shape. It's served as a canvas for glaciers and a waypoint to folks canoeing the lake down below. It's served as a project site and a hiking place, and also just a good spot to stop and catch your breath for a while. Here, I'm reminded that the same place can hold 100 seasons of life. So here's to living in the Upper Peninsula for as long as I can. And if you're in a long, unbroken stretch too, I wish you safety and moments of rest and deep joy and some good people to join you for the ride. And of course, here's to Sugarloaf Mountain in October. Thanks for tagging along, and I'll see you next time for a video about an invention that saved 1,000 ships and has probably saved your life, too. See you soon.